I am Kulsum of Standard 8, studying in Mount English School. I want to thank International Students Bridge Organization, Toronto, Canada, for assigning me important topic. My topic name is How to Improve Reading. The best way to improve your reading comprehension level is through practice. There is no better way to practice reading other than having fun with it. Make reading a fun activity instead of a constant chore. This will motivate you to engage with the text and embrace the activity as part of your daily life. As you practice and truly engage with your reading material, improvement will come naturally. Begin by reading texts that are slightly below your age and grade level. This will take pressure off you and allow you to relax and enjoy the story. Once you feel more comfortable reading and practicing comprehension stages, go ahead and allow yourself to read at whatever reading or age level you feel like. Even if you feel that you do not understand some of the text right now, or even a large portion of it, if you enjoy yourself and give it your best shot, you will find that your reading comprehension levels will improve over time. Read as often as you can. The more you read, the easier it becomes. Practicing for at least 15 to 30 minutes a day, every day will make a big difference. Read something you are interested in. If you have a choice, it's not a surprise that you will be more motivated to read a text that you generally care about. Here are 5 tips to improve your reading. First, do not rush while you are reading. Be calm and concentrate. Second, when you read a book or anything else, read it at aloud to yourself so that you get used to speaking the language. With time, your pronunciation will improve. Third, while reading in your mind, focus on the text in front of you and do not think about anything else. Fourth, read one paragraph at a time and summarize it in one sentence. That will help you reveal the main idea. Fifth, ask yourself questions throughout the reading. If you can, make small notes about the characters or the plot. Sixth, if you do not understand a word, find out what it means. You can Google a word if you do not understand. For example, search define comprehension. Once you feel to learn, you will be forever free. The more that you read, the more things you will understand. Thank you. Everybody, good morning. I am Umme Kulsum of Standard 8, studying in Mount English School. Thank you for being here today and hope everybody is doing fine. I am very glad to see you here and would like to thank International Students Bridge Organization, Toronto, Canada, for assigning me a very important topic. The topic I will present today is the value and importance of thank you. Thank you is a powerful pair of words, and thank you is the key that opens the door to instant happiness. Almighty God said, first you thank to my people, then you thank to me. Saying thank you, it's everybody's attitude and a simply courtesy that takes just a movement. It costs nothing, not even efforts. For sure, they will respect you when you say thank you to them with smile. The fact is that thank you has something truly magic about it. It is just word, but it acts as shorthand for so much more. Thank you shows our appreciation and conveys our gratitude. We should never feel shy to say thank you. And if we say thank you, people love you and like you as a good person. How often has you felt bad because you forget to say thank you or didn't take a moment to thank someone properly? If someone failed to say thank you to you when you are expecting from them, you might feel bad, and the same way if you feel to say thank you to them, they might feel the same way as yours. The message is clear. Forgetting or neglecting to say thank you is rude. Not only does it upset and annoy people, it makes you look bad, however important or busy you are. It's always right to say thank you for even small the thing they have done for you. When you give food or money to a beggar, he prays for you and family. We should say thank you to the beggar for coming to our house and providing us reward from Almighty God. We should say thank you to our housemate for helping us family in daily housework. We should say thank you to our teachers, youngers, elders, friends, neighbors, and others as you wish. Sometimes people say bad words to you, and if you reply thank you with smile, they might think bad later they have done wrong and feel sorry for their attitude. By saying thank you can bring smile and makes other happy. If possible, you can please share this topic with others. I will conclude my topic by saying thank you very much and sincerely appreciate for listening me with patience. Thank you. Everybody, I am Kulsum of Standard 8, studying in Mount Well English School. Firstly, I want to thank International Students Bridge Organization, Toronto, Canada, for assigning me another valuable topic. The topic I will present today is, what are my responsibilities towards my neighbors? A man is not a believer who fills his stomach while his neighbor is hungry. To understand the duties a person has to their neighbor, it is important to first understand what a neighbor is. The neighbor includes the people who live adjoining or connected to your house. It also includes the people who live in near or far houses. It does not matter if your neighbor is Muslim or non-Muslim, practicing Islam or not, a friend or an enemy, a foreigner or a national. You have duties towards them. These are your duties towards our neighbors. Protect their interests when they are absent. Show them respect when they are present. Help them when they are faced with injustice. Do not go out of your way to find their faults. If you know any of their faults, hide them. Never leave them alone during a calamity or a problem. Forgive them if they have done any wrong. In short, I will live with them a peaceful and noble life based on the highest Islamic ethical code. Some examples of completing these duties include kind treatment, sharing food, visiting them during sickness, sad movements and happy movements, not causing any harm, exchanging gifts or greetings. It is clear that with good intentions, every single deed of the believer counts near the Almighty and will get its reward eventually. That is why our Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has directed us to share every small good thing with our neighbors. I will conclude this topic by saying to myself and the brothers and sisters that if our neighbors are happy, Almighty God is happy. Thank you.